Joe Straehle, you have quite an eventful year behind you after buying BSI and maybe getting a little bit more than you bargained for. How's your strategy changed after that deal?
Not really. I think our strategy definitely is based on size. We have enlarged our business by combining basically the two businesses. I think in today's environment, matter counts and is very important at the end of the day. And I think in addition to what we already have from a regional point of view, you know, we could add actually quite some more regions. And I think with this overall, we could build actually quite a solid and big platform.
So size does matter in private banking, but it also matters in terms of your spending and keeping a lid on it. And how are the synergies? I think you had originally said you want to get about 240 million Swiss francs out of the deal. Mm-hmm. How do you see those going?
We are absolutely on track with our saving efforts. And as you know, we basically said 240 million by 2019. And what we see, and I think you've already seen it in the midst of the year, that this now is coming in gradually. So by the end, we should be at the 240 million.
So is this year sort of a year of just working on that deal and then looking for growth afterwards? And if so, where would you look for that growth when you're in that combined setup?
Mm-hmm. I think combining basically both business already gives you quite a boost. And I think having then the synergies, so the cost synergies, basically building this platform is the next step, which we almost finished. The only thing which is missing now is essentially the IT migration here in Switzerland. Everything was on plan so far, has been done. So this is the last piece of the puzzle which is missing. And then I think we will focus more on growth again, because it's obvious that from a managerial point of view, right now the focus is a little bit more on integration. But now gradually I already see it in the first half of this year, that management focuses now on growth again.
That's understandable. And where do you actually see that growth coming from?
Well, the good news is that we have now a good size. We have very good figures in terms of capital, etc. And I think regionally, you know, you clearly see that obviously Asia, I think Europe, Switzerland and LATAM are definitely the areas where we will focus on.
Okay, so in terms of Switzerland and maybe just wider Europe as well, I guess you're not totally out of the woods there, because you have a bit of trouble that you've inherited also from BSI. Mm-hmm. How tricky or how dangerous is that going to be for you, do you think?
Well, I'm sure you talk about Italy.
I am.
And when I just look at this piece, actually that's a very small piece. Obviously, we have to go through the motions. Italy is to us an important market, and I think it's just actually the onshore piece, which again, as I said, is a very small piece, but the offshore piece still is very important to us, and we will continue doing that. But obviously having good relationships with the regulator is very important to us, and we comply fully with everything we have to do. But I think that's also a part of the integration where we have to work on.
Okay, fair enough. And you also got a large new shareholder through this purchase of BSI. And I'm just wondering, you've always had an anchor shareholder, of course, the Latsis family of Greece. Mm-hmm. How stable is that structure now with two actually quite large shareholders?
I think both shareholders are completely committed to this deal, and obviously hope that we can create something much bigger. Mm-hmm. And as you already seen, I think also that the market now slowly realizes that this creates some value, and therefore, you know, I think both shareholders will stay nicely and committed to our strategy.
Very good. I look forward to seeing that play out. Joe Straehle, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.